those days, it was known as Lutea. In addition to being the most studied language in the world after English, French is one of the Romance languages, along with Italian and Spanish. All of these languages have their beginnings in Latin. We all used to speak Latin, I think, didn't we? I know the Romans spoke Latin, but it makes you think sometimes, like in Hollywood, in the movies, right, when everyone's speaking plain English, you know, when in fact, like, you know, they'd all be speaking Latin. So, like, in the movie Gladiator, Russell Crowe, he would be speaking Latin. The French army was the first to use camouflage during World War One. Artists painted vehicles and equipment to blend in into their respective backgrounds. To be fair though, there wasn't much call for camouflage, you know, in the First World War. It was kind of just, it was a stalemate, you know. I think, to be fair, if they'd used camouflage better, then there wouldn't have been as many casualties, because if you look at the way they fought, the tactics, it was absolutely insane by today's standards, you know. Over one half of the traffic roundabouts in the world are located in France. In the Second World War, when Hitler visited the Eiffel Tower, the French cut all the lift cables. This forced him to climb the stairs if he wanted to enjoy the view from the top. So, that's what you call true resistance, guys. You know, a last little bit of defiance. In 2017, French President Emmanuel Macron became the youngest ever president of his country at the age of 39. They had a lot of troubles, you know, a lot of riots. I don't know if it's still going on now, guys, but France has been in a state of uncertainty for a while now, with protesters and the law enforcement clashing. A lot of violent riots going on. King Louis I'm not sure how you say that, guys, it's XIX, had the shortest reign in history, 20 minutes. His father had abdicated the throne, and Louis followed him in abdicating in favour of his nephew. I'm guessing he wasn't cut out to be a leader then. He didn't even try to stick out, he just thought, no, I don't want any of that. Number 10. France made history in 2016 by banning supermarkets from throwing out unsold food items. These stores are now required to donate food to charities and food banks. That's an excellent idea, guys. I think all countries in the world should be doing that. You know, no food should be wasted at all. You know, there are people in desperate need of food, and if there's spare food there, then why not, you know? You know, I think we're a very wasteful society regarding food and power usage and everything, you know. I do think we all need to do a bit to cut back, you know, to stop on wastage. During the Second World War, the Mosque of Paris protected French Jews from the Nazis by supplying them with Muslim identification cards. The well-known bicycle race in the world, the Tour de because sometimes, you know, death is too easy, you know. I think it's, if you want to punish somebody, making them live a life they don't want to is punishment enough. You know, it's a fate worse than death, as they say. But I know the Bible says an eye for an eye, but I'm not sure, because you know, if you take a, you know, if a man murders another man, then the number of murderers in the world remain the same. I can't remember if that's the Bible or Batman that said that. Always forward thinking, the French were the first to introduce the concept of license plates for automobiles in 1893. The capital of France is Paris. It has a population of about 2.3 million. The French government has mandated that at least 40% of all music played on private radio stations in the country be of French origin. Half of that quota of French music is also required to be less than 6 months old. In total land area, France is the largest country in the European Union. Well, we just left the European Union, didn't we? Brexit and all the rest of it. Between 1814 and 1830, the official flag of the Kingdom of France was simply a plain white field with no other colours, symbols or borders. The famous Lascaux, spelled L-A-S-C-A-U-X, caves in France have rock paintings in them dating back over 17,000 years. The Louvre Museum in Paris is consistently the most visited museum in the world. Over 9 million visitors go through their doors annually. Number 22. By the 1660s, France already had a form of public transportation. It consisted of horse-drawn wagons that followed a set schedule along specific routes, or routes if you're American. 23. For 214 years, it was legal in Paris for two women to wear pants. For women to wear pants. This ended in 2012. Bloody hell. 2012, it took them all that time for women to wear pants. That's ridiculous. That's proper sexist, that is. Hey, we live in a misogynistic society. The highest mountain in France is Mont Blanc at 15,780 feet. Mont Blanc is part of the French Alps. Despite France's reputation as a colouring mecca, French males have the lowest percentage of obesity in Europe. Oh, that's actually quite good. Maybe we should all take a leaf out of France's book and tackle obesity. There's definitely a crisis in this country. In order to be a taxi driver in Paris, you would have to pay almost €200,000 to get your license. France is divided into 13 regions, which are divided into 101 departments. There are also 5 ROMs, or overseas regions, which are part of France. In December 2015, the regions were recognised to the 13 regions, down from the previous number of 22. I didn't get that fact, guys. I'm not as smart as you, please bear with me. In the world was, according to the Guinness Book of Records, a French woman who lived to be 122 years old and 164 days. 122 years and 164 days old. Wow, that's some lifetime. No country has won more Nobel Prizes for literature than France. The French rail system at 29,000 kilometres is second only to Germany's in length. The actual name France came from a Germanic tribe. They used the word Frank, which meant free, in their native tongue. Champagne comes exclusively from the Champagne region of France. If it doesn't come from there, it is simply referred to as sparkling wine. That's quite interesting. 33. Contrary to the popular myth, Napoleon was in fact How do they know this, guys? At the end of the day, you'd have to see him with your own eyes to know. Approximately 85% of French population resides in cities. In another oddity of French royalty, King John I was named King 5 months before he was actually born. Unfortunately, he only survived 5 days. With its amazing history, it isn't surprising that France has 28 UNESCO World Heritage Sites, 37 courtesy counts in France. There is even a coffee shop where not saying hello and, oh, I get it now, courtesy counts in France. There is even a coffee shop where not saying hello and please will increase the cost of your beverage. That's actually a great idea, guys, you know. But you should really know your manners. You know, manners cost nothing. Depending on the source, there are between 350 and 450 different types of French cheese. There are also many varieties of each type, leading some to claim that there are 1,000 types of French cheese. 1,000 types of cheese, bloody hell. You'd have to eat, like, I don't know. Like, if you tried a different cheese every day, it'd take you 1,000 days. The French are responsible for creating the metric system of weights and measures in 1793. Potatoes were once illegal in France between 1748 and 1772. The French thought that potatoes caused leprosy. French wine consumption is legendary, with 11.2 billion glasses enjoyed each year. That's a lot of liters of wine. 42. French writer Marcel Proust holds the record for the longest novel ever written. Remembrance of Things Past is over 3,000 pages in length. It is 13 volumes and involves thousands of characters. Nah, I wouldn't have the patience to sit there and read a book with 3,000 pages. I used to love reading as a kid. I read all the Harry Potter novels and everything, but 3,000 pages, just turn it into a movie or a TV series. 43. The current French flag is known as the tricolour for its blue, white and red stripes. It was created as part of the French Revolution in 1794. Ironically, the oldest bridge in Paris is named the Pont Neuf, which means new bridge. Europe's busiest railway station and one of the oldest in the world is Paris Gare du Nord. 190 million passengers go through the station each year. 46. Recognising how important and difficult parenting can be, the French government awards medals to citizens who have successfully raised several children with dignity. Wow. For its importance, not only as food, but as an integral part of French social interaction, UNESCO has recognised French gastronomy with a World Heritage Site designation. 48. Because the French Empire was so wide-ranging, today there are more French-speaking individuals in Africa than there are in France. Wow. 49. At one point in France's empire had control of 8% of all the land in the world. 50. Is it 50? I think in Spanish, I'm not sure. France has the second largest population of all European countries. advances among the top exporting countries in the world when it comes to luxury items, with companies like Louis Vuitton, Chanel and Cartier. That's hardly surprising. 56. Historically speaking, the cities of Paris has endured a lot over the years. This may account for its motto: she may be tossed by the waves, but she does not sink. Despite its reputation for romance, a 1910 law forbids couples from kissing on train platforms. Apparently the practice delayed too many departures. The world's first artificial heart transplant took place in Paris, France, in December 2013. If a non-French individual serving in the French Foreign Legion is wounded in the defence of France, he is able to apply for a French citizenship, since he is then considered to be French by spilled blood. They're a tough band of soldiers, are the French Foreign Legion. If not for a French inventor, there would be no selfies. Philippe Kahn invented the cell phone camera in 1997. God bless the man. Or woman, I'm not sure. Yeah, Philippe is a woman's name. No, a man's name, isn't it? 61. The largest lake in France is the spectacular Lake Geneva. It covers 582 square kilometres. Chateaus are iconic structures in France with good reason. There are roughly 40,000 of them, in part because of the museums, in part because of the cuisine, and in part due to its natural beauty. France is the single most visited country in the world. France's legal system is based primarily on the Napoleonic Code, which was created following the French Revolution. Not that the circumstance arises very often, but in France, under the proper circumstances, it is possible to marry someone who is deceased. There is a very strict set of guidelines which must be followed, but it is possible. Number one, why does that law exist? Number two, why would you even want to marry a dead person? 66. Lovers of both the culinary arts and literature, the French publish an average of 2 new cookbooks each day. Despite the incredible amount of traffic, there is not one stop sign in the entire city of Paris. There are no left turn signs as well as do not enter signs, but not one red octagonal stop sign. So what happens if you need to stop, or how do they know when to stop? I lost where I was, guys, sorry. We'll just do two more. Of all countries which observe an Independence Day, 26 of them celebrate their independence from France. Let's see, one more. Let's get a good one. Thanks to the French education system, 99% of the population 15 and older are literate. That's a good fact, because it's a basic human right to be able to read and write. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was nice and relaxing and that you learned something. I just wanted to say this. Please hit the subscribe button, guys. I'm in desperate need of subscribers. You know, I really want to get the channel growing, and you know, I really want to develop it and get my content out there for a wider range of people, you know, for a bigger audience. So whatever my videos are greatly received, I'll keep on doing them. But let me know that you like my videos by pressing the like button, please, guys. It means a lot, so smash the hell out of that subscribe button. Anyway, guys, I'll leave you to it, and I hope to see you all. Well, I hope that you all stick around for my next video. Okay, guys, take care.